Alright guys, Jonathan here. I'm still in Dubai and I'm now going to do a DJ mixing tutorial on mixing Arabic style dance music. Now what I find when I go to a new country, I try and get involved as much as I can with the country itself. I don't take my ways to the country. I hopefully try and become a part of that country. So I like to go to real markets. I like to go and see the real people, not just go to the holiday resorts. And I also like to take advantage of the music they've got and see if it inspires me. And I've always liked different genres of music. I have to admit, this is absolutely stunning. I picked up this album and it is the Arabian Club Night number 2. There it is. I'm going to use 2 tracks. And right, on the way back from picking these up, we put this CD in the car, and we put the first track in, and to begin with I was thinking, all right, it's not that bad. But then you ended up having this just thumping bass. The way of describing it, it's almost like Arabic-style progressive house with a very, very mellow vibe. It's almost as though you could feel as though you're just floating away on a magic carpet. I will put, if I can find the videos on YouTube, I'll put the links in the description so you can go and check it out, check the 2 tunes out. And if you do have the time and you've got a PA system or a banging PA system, turn it up because the bass is phenomenal. Now, one thing with this style of music, there is a lot of music going on, so you need to be careful about mixing the tracks. So what I've got here, I've got track 14 from disc 2, track 1 from disc 1, is I'm going to mix in the beginning like so. It's a tiny bit at the beginning, and then we have track 1 from disc 1. It's almost got that psytrance feel as well, but it hasn't got that gurgling kind of psytrance bass. It, like I said, it's very progressive, so it's just the wrong one. I have it too loud. It's honestly, it's just, there's something about this. We played it and it was like, you know what? Immense, absolutely immense. Okay, so let's just put that down a minute. Now, with most European dance music, when you have a dance track, it will start off from the count of 1. Very, very rarely will you have some form of introduction. And even more rarely will you have some form of introduction where there's no real beat. There's nowhere where you can say 1, 2, 3, 4. So if you have a listen to this one here, crossfade, start again. This is how it starts. This is exactly how it starts. Right, I'm just gonna pause it. We'll put it back, it's right at the beginning. I'm now going to take some hot cues. I'm going to record right at the beginning of the track, making note of my levels as well. Very important. That will become apparent later on in this tutorial. If I just do this now, if I actually put the camera there so it's a little bit closer. I'm going to record, get a hot cue on the first kick of the first beat. 1, 2. I've got one more hot cue left, so we'll go back to the beginning, get on to record again, and now I've got B here that I can do-do-do-do-do. Have a listen. There. I think just maybe we'll do it about there. No, actually, you should have done it from the first place there. that's already got, it's got melody, it's got a bit of feel. What I want to try and do now is add an effect to that, but I don't want to take over from the beauty of the sound that we're getting. So I'm going to go for a flanger, and really, timing here, there isn't much timing with the beginning. Well, there is timing with the beginning of this track, but this is down to your ear, how much you want the flanger to work over the beginning of the track. So if we just press play again, have a listen. There you go. Filter as well. That's all well and good, but that's the track we want to mix in to this one here. Pain in the Middle East. I don't think this is a pain, I think this is an absolutely killer cut. On my travels around the world, I do get to listen to some wicked music, and this is no exception. Again, every single track is different. Every single track tells a story. So my own thought on this cut here is I don't think I'd want to mix another track in halfway through. It's almost as though this is an Arabian night feel. Some guy on a camel is going out there into the desert and he's coming back. He doesn't want to go halfway to the desert and be told he's got to come back. He needs to take his journey. This track is the entire journey. So I wouldn't want to touch, when I say wouldn't want to touch the track, I don't think I'd want to mix something in halfway through. Because if you took away this beat, if you took away the beat, the bass line, you're left with that beautiful melody in the background, and that melody tells a story, and it would be a shame to stop that story from being told. I do apologise. Okay, but what I'll do, pause that up, remember we've got our hot cue. There, we've got that ready. So, I'm going to put it forward. I'm going to pause that as well. Now, if you're not familiar with mixing tracks, and this is one of the first videos you've ever seen of mine, what you will always need to make sure is this isn't obligatory. You don't have to do this. This isn't like in one of the major rule books. If you don't do this, you know, you're going to get electrocuted. But it's highly advisable to listen to the end of the track and count back. So, for example, at the last kick, you start counting back. So you don't count bars forward, you count bars back. And depending on how this track that you're going to mix in builds up, for example, if from the start to, let's say, the first change is 16 bars, then maybe you want to then count back 16 bars, bring this one in on the 16th bar before the end, and then work them both together. So of course, as soon as that one finishes, the build starts on the track that's coming in. So let's just have a listen and see how the end of this track ends. Okay, pretty much the same all the way through. You see, again, a different genre, different styles. If this was EDM, electronic dance music, it's highly unlikely it would finish like this. So, if we have another listen again, this is sort of breaking all the rules of EDM. They've just gone, we're gonna do it our own way. It's just a fade out, so it doesn't 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and stop. This has gone, you know what? We're gonna sit on our camel and we're gonna take our camel out into the desert, and you're just gonna see us disappear over the brow of a sand dune, and you're never gonna see us again. So, hold on. Right, we do have a break here. Don't know if you can see that. I'll just sort of zoom in a little bit. We have a break there. So what I'd probably do is start counting from that break. But as this is a demonstration tutorial, I have explained already about counting back. So I'm just gonna start to mix this one in around about here anyway. Here we go. Spent more time mixing this track in, but then I hope you get the idea. This is just beautiful. Very mellow, very chilled out. It's on a progressive side. It's on a progressive side of things, but again, it's got its own character. I hope that's been a help. Have fun, and this is possibly my first, hopefully of many, of Arabian style DJ tutorials. I'd like to say as well a big shout out to the Dubai DJ Academy. If you want any information on playing a part, don't hesitate. Check out the link in the description and have a chat with Claudio or Dieter. Practice and enjoy. Thank you very much.